स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डू द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज बिजनेस एथिक्स। नाउ व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय एथिक्स? एथिक्स मींस द मॉरल कंडक्ट, हाउ वी शुड बिहेव बेसिकली इन पब्लिक लाइफ। दैट इज व्हाट द एथिक्स इज, द मॉरल कंडक्ट ऑफ एनी इंडिविजुअल और एनी इंस्टीट्यूशन। So same applies to every business also. Now when you will say that business ethics means कोई business morally कैसे act कर सकता है, तो business को morally act करना पड़ेगा, क्योंकि वो एक society का part है, वो raw material society से लेता है, वो human resource society से लेता है, वो बैंक्स से जो लोन लेता है वो सोसाइटी की सेविंग्स बैंक्स के थ्रू बिजनेस तक पहुंचाई जाती है इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लोन। सो इट इज़ ड्यू रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ बिजनेस टू एक्ट मॉरली। इट शुड नॉट वर्क एन इमोरल वे। फॉर एग्जांपल, अगर बिजनेस ही ड्रग्स बेचना शुरू कर देगा तो सोसाइटी का क्या होगा? लिक्विड, when we say liquor is harmful for the health, it is the due responsibility of the business to avoid trading into spurious liquid, jo methane based aapke capsule based hain, jo aapke desi liquor hai jisme jisko peene ke baad bahut sare logon ki death ho jati hai, that is an immoral activity. Okay, so it is the due responsibility of the business to do activities in a moral way, in an ethical way, not to go for hire and fire policy. Okay, corona pandemic is going on, but that doesn't give the right to every business organization that they should throw out the people on the basis, on the excuse of corona, out of jobs. Okay, means you are using them as per your own convenience. कि आपको चाहिए तो वापस बुला लो, आपको नहीं चाहिए तो उनको भगा दो यहाँ से। As for the laborers, जब तक आपका काम, आपका lockdown चल रहा था तो आपने अपने का laborers को कह दिया we don't have the work, you survive on your own self. अब जब वो वापस चले गए, now every other businessman is paying tickets to call them back through flights, through railways. Why such an immoral behavior is there from the businessman's side? Businessmen, though they are contributing into the growth of the economies, but they are dependent upon the human resource, the raw material, the services from the society. Then only they can provide the economic objectives, they can fulfill the economic objectives of the country, and in pursual to that they earn profits. Okay, so it is the due responsibility of the businessman to be empathetic and to be working in a moral way, so that they are taking care of not only the society but also they are earning sufficient benefits, so that they can prosper, grow and expand their business activities in a better way. So this is why we say there need to be business ethics, the morality. Okay, so what are the some of the aspects of business ethics? Other can be paying taxes in time, paying proper taxes, not hiding. Like generally business, what the business is doing is they make two different types of bills. Some goods are being billed and some are unbilled goods. Okay, they make fake companies, hide the taxes. Okay, so same way general public is also hiding income tax by not showing proper incomes. So it is duty of the individual concerned as well as the business organizations to pay taxes duly, okay, and in time, so that taxes can contribute towards the growth of the country. Okay, another thing is they should not use unfair weights and measures to fleece the customer. Also, they should provide good quality goods to the customer. Also, their treatment towards the workers or employees should be fair. So all these aspects are being considered, or some of these are the aspects which are related to the ethical conduct of the business towards ethical conduct of the business towards the society, and that is very important in every form of business organization. Now there are certain elements which are related to business ethics. Those elements are, first is the commitment of, now elements of business ethics are there. First is commitment of top management. Okay. No business can act ethically unless until the top management, who is making plans, policies, strategies for any business organization, they feel that the activities of the business should be carried on in an ethical manner. So the behavior of the organization will be ethical only when the top management is acting ethically. If they are establishing ethical code of conduct for the employees and they themselves are implementing it upon them, then only the other employees at the lower levels will implement that ethical code of conduct, and they will work in an ethical way with the various parties. So it is the top management who has to guide and inform or train the employees within the organization as to how their conduct should be ethical, okay, and how they should work morally in a morally best way, so that that can generate enough of the goodwill towards the business organization that this organization is working in a best manner. Okay, for example, these days online education is becoming the most important tool for providing the education. So it is the due responsibility of the top administration in every school, college, university to be duly concerned about the well-being of the students. And it is their due responsibility to see that the content is being delivered properly and in a useful, fruitful way to each and every student who is part of their organization or part of their institution in a proper manner. And if possible, they should be given the platform from where they can have access to the things at any time they want, means their lectures should be available at any time they want to listen to them. So that type of structure should be created by the institutions. Then only we can consider if the top administration is trying to implement those ethical aspects, then the employees who are working at the lower levels, they will also follow the line, they will fulfill the directions which has been laid down by the top officials. But if top officials themselves are not adhering to the code of conduct or the rules and regulations they have implemented, then the people who are working down the line will also not follow. That is why we say there should be commitment of the top management for implementation of the moral ethics in any organization. Okay, first thing. Second thing is publication of code of conduct. Okay, so there should be a rule, set of rules and regulations being published in written manner. They should be explained in a particular document that what are the various rules and regulations of doing job in an organization. For example, some organizations say that their coaching is not allowed in their educational institution. When they have written this particular code of conduct in their books and that has been circulated amongst the employees, then it should be implemented as it has been written. So here comes the first point. The top management has to get it implemented, and the rules of doing work should be published in the proper documentary form. What are the rules of leaves, of getting a leave, casual leave, medical leave, okay? How many leave will be deducted if you if there is prefix or suffix? What will be the implication of not following the rules and regulation and various other things? So the code of conduct should be in the written form, and that document should be circulated amongst all the employees. And it, like, whenever you enter an industry, there are certain rules and regulations being written on the front of a gate, industry gate, that you have to wear helmets, you have to wear your shoes should be such type, your gloves should be there. Nowadays, when people are being sent there, you have to put masks, you have to sanitize your hands. Those are the rules and regulations which are specifically and clearly being written, and it has to be implemented as it is. So code of conduct should be written in the written form, so that nobody can claim that you have not written, you haven't supplied us the written rules and regulation, as a result of which I was not aware. When those rules and regulations are in the written form, they are being circulated amongst the employees, and if the employees do not implement those rules and regulations or do not follow those rules and regulations, strict action can be taken against them. And that is what the another important thing is, that those rules and regulations which the top management has decided and has agreed to implement should be in the written form, and that should be circulated in the organization. Third thing is, there should be compliance mechanism. Okay. Compliance mechanism means how these rules and regulations will be actually implemented in the organizations, okay, means how we are going to ensure that people are trained in those ethics, those moral rules and regulation conducts, okay, that is that has to be established. That plan, that system has to be established, and that is done in some organizations while recruitment. We are, first of all, when we are going to do the recruitment, we have to find out that the person who we are going to recruit in the organization should have some sense of responsibility towards the rules and regulations of any organization in which he is working. If the person concerned whom we are recruiting is a habitual liar or is a habitual rule breaker, so we should not recruit those persons. This is the first step of implementing those code of conduct which we have decided for the organization, that the people whom we are going to recruit, they should be such that who are ready to accept the rules and regulations of the organization and are ready to implement those rules and regulations for the betterment of the organization. Second aspect is the selection aspect and training aspect, where in the selection process and in the training process, where selection process, we will come to know the qualities of those individuals, that what type of those individuals are there, okay, whose application we have accepted, whether they are actually recruitment is a negative process, is a process where we are attracting applications. So first step, we are attracting application of those individuals who are ready to accept the rules and regulations of any organization. In selection process, वी आर एक्चुअली सीइंग दैट दोज इंडिविजुअल हु हैव रिटन दैट आई एम अ लॉ अबाइडिंग इंडिविजुअल वेदर ही इज एक्चुअली अ लॉ अबाइडिंग और रूल रेगुलेशन अबाइडिंग इंडिविजुअल और नॉट. इफ ही इज नॉट ही शुड बी शंटेड आउट फ्रॉम the organization during the selection procedure. And once that individual has been selected in the organization, now during the training program also he should be given training to implement those rules and regulations which we expect him to implement, and that is what the procedure is. Okay, so this is that their various steps should be followed to implement the rules and regulations, the code of conduct in the organization, and these should be there should be a proper communication system established in the organization so that employees can easily report regarding various problems they are facing in implementing rules and regulations and in understanding various rules and regulations so that unethical activities can be cut down to the lowest level. That is what the compliance mechanism is. Okay, compliance mechanism means how to implement the code of conduct which has been established or which has been written and circulated amongst the employees in an organization. And next is it involves it leads to involving all employees at different levels. Okay, the another important thing is while deciding code of conduct, it is the due responsibility of the top management to get the suggestions from all the employees in the organization whether we should do this or not, whether we should implement this rule regulation in the organization, how it will leave an impact, positive or negative, at what level it will be positive and what level it will be negative, and how, what will be the results, outcome of these rules and regulations. So before making rules and regulation and implementing those rules and regulation, it is the due responsibility of the top management to get the suggestion, to ask for the suggestions from various individuals in the organization at various levels, from the top to lowest level. And after getting those suggestions, after understanding those suggestions, a set of rules and regulations should be made which is being accepted by all the employees working at different level. If it is being done, then only it can be properly implemented, because if you leave certain section of employees out of the rule regulation implementation or making process, they will feel neglected and they will stop, shirk to accept those changes, those rules and regulation, and they will also shirk to implement those rules and regulation into the system, and that can be harmful for the growth and expansion and smooth functioning of the organization. That is the another important aspect. Okay, then there is measuring results. Okay, the last important thing in business ethics is that once you have prepared code of conduct, you have started implementing it into the organization, it is the due responsibility of the top management to see the impact of those rules and regulation or code of conduct which has been implemented in the organization, how far and how better these rules and regulations have made an impact in the organization, what betterment it has brought in into the working of the organizational structure, and how it has improved upon the satisfaction level of employees, the performance of the employees, and the betterment of the organization, how it has acted. That need to be measured and that need to be compared, what was expected and what we have accomplished. And if there are certain lacunas that need to be sorted out, and if we have crossed the levels which we were expecting, then we need to re-review our code of conduct so that we can re-establish a better standards and can get better results for the organization. So that is the last point in this, that whatever the rules and regulations you are establishing in the organization, it is very important that you need to review the impact of those code of conduct and understand why we are not achieving the target results, and if we have achieved the target results, whether we have set the bar lower to achieve those targets, and if the bar has been set lower, then we need to raise the standard, need to raise the bar so that we can accomplish better results and become a better organization. So that is what business ethics, measuring of results in business ethics is. So this is all we have to understand in business ethics. This is the last topic. Thanks.